unit rate, a la Shmoop. Have you ever wondered how to compare two entirely different categories of terms, such as warthogs and distance?
I don't know, you tell me.
Here is where a rate comes in handy.
Ooh.
It's important to use rates for good, not evil. An important message to all future mechanics out there.
Got your oil changed.
In math, a rate is a comparison, or ratio, between two terms that are measured in different units. If you were to come across 60 warthogs over a 2-mile stretch, we'd suggest you get the heck out of there. Those things are vicious.
Well, I'll protect you.
In mathematical terms, the incidence of warthogs can be expressed as a rate of 60 warthogs for 2 miles. However, a unit rate reduces one of the terms to a single unit. It's like magic.
You shall not pass!
Or, to use a highly technical term, math. So, we have a unit rate of 30 warthogs per mile. You might be thinking,
fine. Now I know what a unit rate is, but when will I ever need to compare warthogs to miles?
Touché, but what about our candy bars per dollar? If a candy bar is $1.50, how many candy bars would you get for your dollar? All right, we gave you a tricky one. The answer is 2/3 of a candy bar. And when is that ever enough? Unit rates are used all the time in our everyday lives, such as miles per hour for driving, dollars and cents per pound when buying food, and points per game in basketball. Without unit rates, the world would be a vastly more complicated place.
Random burn.
We wouldn't know how many miles per gallon our vehicles receive.
Not again.
Or how many calories per meal we should eat to meet our nutritional goals, assuming we have any.
What? I'm trying to bulk up.
Even many professional writers, including freelance journalists, are paid by the word.
Must make rent!
Unit rates are all around us, and they help keep the world from descending into chaos. Let's hear it for unit rates, keeping the world from falling into disorder. We thank you on behalf of Need Freaks Everywhere.